Other researchers have looked at domains within moral reasoning. There are moral rules that pertain to our concepts of harm and welfare and fairness. There are also social conventional rules. Social convention is concerned with social order and organization, and that's something that's a little more subjective, more arbitrary. These are rules that we expect people who live in our society to follow, but maybe don't directly reflect our principles. They aren't vital to our ideas of morality. Morality tends to be universal. It doesn't matter who you ask, what country they come from, or what culture they come from. Killing another person is not considered okay. That tends to be universal. Hurting people and causing them pain is not okay. Taking other people's things is not okay. That tends to be true regardless of where you grew up and regardless of who your parents were. Whereas social convention tends to be fairly arbitrary. These are things like driving on the right-hand side of the road versus the left-hand side of the road, the convention that it's okay for men to walk around topless but not women. These are the kinds of things that, while we have a hard time going against those rules, they're not generally considered a reflection of morality. They're not considered to be protecting people from harm. Moral issues and social conventional issues are different things, but sometimes they intersect. This is outside of a record store in the UK. The point I want to make here is that social conventions like lining up in a queue are sometimes in the service of preserving morality. Things like fairness. It's fair that the people who are in the front of the line, the people who've been waiting the longest, get to go into the store first, and that the people who just got there have to wait. Sometimes social conventions and our ideas of morality work together. Even though they're separate things, oftentimes they can overlap.